thank you for watching this video, subscribe to my channel. Look, a lot of folks want to call themselves blessed. And of course, if you see blessed or cursed, of course you would prefer blessed. That's a rational, natural thing to do. But you do realize that during this lifetime, for you to be blessed also implies that you are a target. Yes, I've said it. A lot of folks, when they come to the Lord, they want blessings. They have these expectations, these worldly expectations, that they get some relief outcome, that they are left alone. No, it's not going to happen that way. Okay, let me give an illustration. Let's say you have just a community, a town now, and suddenly you have this singer that appears and begins to sing. Nobody knows the guy. People think, who is this guy singing all the time? And they develop a dislike, an aversive attachment towards the guy. Later, they find out that this guy is a famous singer from China and think, what? This is in China? But here's the thing. That guy is now promoted by mainstream media. So what's happening now? They're now encountered. They're now actually encounter his singing talent, whether they agree it's talent or not, all the time. Because when they enter a mall, they're calling from demons again, but okay. Where they enter a mall or they are in a cafeteria, the songs of that guy is played. They're the ones with an aversive attachment, right? That singer did not make them become aversive. They did. So now they are triggered in pain all the time. They encounter things of that guy. So who needs to seek help? They do. Who needs to evaluate themselves? They do. Are they going to do it? No. So what happens now? They're all triggered. They're all upset. And now they wanted to relieve it on someone else. That's how people in the world are. So even unbelievers amongst each other are not always safe amongst each other. Look at the homicide rate. Look in the world. Most of the time when someone is killed, it's by someone they knew. Someone gained some influence, others didn't want to put up with that influence, so they acted out. That's how it goes in this world. So why do you think that you, as a believer, you have the power, that now suddenly they're all going to be at ease and in harmony with you? It's not going to happen. I'm telling you, it's not going to happen. Not today, not until Christ returns. It will not happen. When you are blessed, let us take the example of Job. A lot of people read the book of Job and look at how Job lost everything, and they look at how the friends of Job reacted. Well, friends, if you can call those people friends. But just evaluate Job's circumstances afterwards, how people treated Job afterwards. When Job was empowered to produce riches, people were respectful towards him. The moment he lost, the moment the Holy Spirit took that away, and the Holy Spirit permitted Satan to attack him, well, not really attack him, things he had around him, forgive me, attack what he had, because Job was covered all the time. The moment that happened, the true colors of those people appeared. Because Job had this empowerment, people knew if we do something to Job, we are in trouble. So they find a way to deal with Job's influence. Now that Job lost influence, now they felt free and empowered to act out their will against Job. That's also something that Job endured. And let me tell you, saint, I'm talking to those that are in agreement with Christ. That's why I said saint. I'm not talking about people that go to church every time, pray so many times a day. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about those that agree with Christ. There are people out there who don't dare to even look dirty at you because they know there's power with you. That's why you can walk at ease in many places and nobody does anything. It's not because those people are so at peace with you. They're not. They are in the negative. And they are hating on you because you are empowered. Because they can't will against that empowerment. If they could, well, let me say like this. If you had someone that was bragging about his kid being a good football player, then anyone else would say, well, I don't agree with that. That kid plays like crap. They could will against it. But when you are blessed, nobody can will against that. And that's what they are upset about, because they want to have the last word. They want to become God. They are envious because they can't will against the empowerment you have. If you had the paranormal charm, if it was not from the Holy Spirit, if it was not a blessing but a paranormal charm, they somehow could have still willed against it. But because it's the blessing, it's supernatural, they can't do it. And that's why they turn on you. When you are blessed, you are also a target in this world. Both by the target of unclean spirits and of envious people who don't want to give up relief seeking. Look, When you do something other people don't find interesting, they can will against you, become annoyed at you. But when you are empowered and they can't will against you and they have to put up with your own frustration, man, they'll lose it. This whole idea that you need to leave people alone, hold on a minute, they need to give up those wrong expectations. Yes, you should comply with some external stuff like traffic signs, that you don't speak too loud in the supermarket, for example. So there are things you comply with, but this whole idea that you are obliged to give people ease, I'm sorry, that's not biblical. That's even against common sense. People that are relief-centered, that don't want to let go, they hold on to those restrictions, they will seek to restrict others. And when you are blessed, you're not restricted. You overrule the restrictions around you. When they can't stand you, when they don't like you, when they begin to ignore you, make you feel bad, you overrule it. And what's left with them? They're now humiliated. Did you humiliate them? No. That's the consequence of them holding on to that will. But now, you need to leave them alone. No, they need to repent. So stop taking their blame, because you're not to blame. They should not be in the negative, period. Just understand, when you are blessed, you're also a target. So, I'm saying, deal with it. I'm not saying this. I said, I'm not angry at you. I'm not cussing you out or anything. I'm just telling you, deal with it. Being blessed also implies that you are a target. I know there are churches that don't tell you this. I'm not a Joel Osteen type of preacher that's going to tell things to make you feel good. I'm not hating Joel Osteen or anything like that, but I'm not into that style. I'm telling you as it is. As a believer, as someone that's blessed, you will endure persecution. That's what Christ said, in the world you have tribulation, but be of good cheer, I've overcome the world. So seek the overcoming. Overrule evil with good. Be at peace.